Good afternoon, everybody. I speak as a clergy person of the United Church of Christ, one of many faith denominations who uphold healthcare as a right for all and consider it a moral crisis that it remains a privilege for the few. For the working poor or average person to not be able to afford going to the doctor creates a moral issue, not only a moral issue, but a threat to our public health. My faith teaches that we cannot serve two masters. We cannot serve both God and money. We can either act in greed or serve in love. Dr. King once said that justice is what love looks like in public, and so I ask our elected officials today to serve in love and do justice this season by passing this legislation. The ones who suffer the most in our society for lack of health care continue to be women, children, the elderly, and the infirm. Dr. King also once said, of all forms of inequality, injustice in health care is the most shocking and inhumane. I believe that within our human conscience, we know that ensuring health care for all citizens as a free and universal right is not only the sensible and affordable thing to do, it is also the morally just and right thing to do. Poverty is not a choice. Poverty is violence when $1.4 trillion is transferred from the working poor and middle classes to the wealthiest 1%. When the top 1% already has as much wealth as the bottom 90, we know, we see, we feel the violence of poverty, and it is literally keeping us sick. In this time of moral crisis, it remains the job of the elected officials in our democracy to uphold the common good and the health of the whole of civil society, especially the vulnerable. In a time when we live in the wealthiest country in the world, and yet among the nations of the world, ranked 37th in providing health care for all citizens, we must ask our elected officials if they are acting in greed or serving in love for justice. In a country where the cost of health care has made going to the doctor a luxury and turned a serious illness into a sentence of deep poverty for even middle-class people, we must ask our elected officials if they are acting in greed or serving in love for the common good. When we as a country invest billions in expanding the nuclear arsenal, when we already have enough bombs to burn the world 7 times over, and yet we are conditioned to think of it as pie in the sky to actually help each other and provide all citizens with the means for good health, we must ask our elected officials if they are acting in greed or serving in love for the people that they work for. And no, corporations are not people made in the image of God. Lift off the ground, we all have to be prepared to remind our officials who they work for. I want to ask our elected officials today, when you have the opportunity to vote on this legislation, are you going to vote to line the pockets of the CEOs of insurance companies, or are you going to do the practical, sensible, and morally just thing and uphold healthcare as a free and universal right for all rather than a luxury for the few? Are you going to serve money or serve God? I ask you to be blessed and to serve in love in regards to this issue. Until then, we the people are going to continue sounding the alarm and declare moral crisis until healthcare is free and a universal right for all citizens. God bless you and God bring into being the beloved community. And let's get a chant going. The fight, we're all going to yell, healthcare is a right. Don't give up the fight!
Healthcare is a right!